I'm Cate Dollard. I teach biology at Northampton High School. Transfer goals all have to do really with experimentation, to understanding how experiments are designed, how to collect data, and I guess most importantly, how to analyze data. In life, they're going to see graphs in the newspaper, they're going to see results of experiments published, and they need to be knowledgeable in how to know if that's a good experiment or not. Do I trust the results? What other questions do I have about it? In the classroom that you filmed today, the students are looking at zebrafish. It's a genetics experiment, and they're observing phenotypes, how the different fish in the dish look, and they're going to be making some conclusions based on the ratio of the fish as to what their parents' genotypes are. In terms of the transfer goals, they're doing observation, they're collecting data. Tomorrow they're going to analyze data, so they're going to see the difference between the conclusions that you can make from the data from one group, which is a small amount of data, and then when we look at the data as a whole class, they'll see that you can't make the conclusions that you need to make without looking at the large body of data. And as the course goes on, they are asked to gain more and more independence in doing these tasks and designing their own experiment and deciding how they're going to collect the data. As in any goal setting, sometimes it seems like an obvious thing that I want to work on it, but I think when you say that you're going to do it and that that's an important part of what you're doing, then you're much more focused about making sure you achieve those goals.